I like to show an example on how to convert this grammar into Chomsky normal form. In the Chomsky normal form, there are only a specific type of rules allowed. One type is that you have on the left-hand side a non-terminal, and on the right-hand side you have exactly two non-terminals. I call them here in this example S2 and S3. So it's not allowed to have more than two non-terminals on the right-hand side and not less than two. And the other type of rule that's allowed is that you have one non-terminal on the left-hand side and a single terminal on the right-hand side. And again, you are not allowed to have more than one or less than one. And to create the Chomsky normal form, you have to do several steps. And I will link you in the video description videos where I explain each of the steps. And you can basically choose in which order you want to do those steps. But if you are unlucky, then you have to repeat steps to create a Chomsky normal form. So I choose a good order in this video here. So a first good step is to remove epsilon productions. And in this case, it's a good point to start because we have only this one epsilon production. And as you may see or have seen in the part videos, if those d becomes an empty string, it's the same. Well, if you have this, it would be the same as if the d at the end isn't there anymore. So I can replace those rules. For example, if the d would become the empty string in this case, I would have a single b, and I just skip the step, so I don't need those d anymore. And again, the same with ad, so I add just a single a to it. And here we have the same. I replace this rule by the new rule where b becomes only a because we don't need the d anymore. So, now I can take out this rule, and I removed the only epsilon production that was there. And whatever step I do next, there won't come any new epsilon production into it. So, the next step I do is to remove useless variables. Oh, sorry. Useless variables or non-terminals. And well, I took out the rule with the d, so I don't need the d in the grammar definition anymore. And besides that, we can have two kinds of useless variables. One useless variable would be one that you can't use in a derivation because you can't reach it from a start symbol, or the other one would be useless because it never terminates. Well, we can have a short look at it. From the S you can reach a B and a in the derivation, and from A you can reach a C. So all those non-terminals are maybe reached in a derivation. And we can also look if they all would terminate, because if you can see here, the B terminates when it becomes an A. And as you can see, C can terminate because it can become a B as well. The same for A. And so, well, S uses B and A, so S can terminate as well. So we don't have any other useless variables besides that. The third step would be to remove chain rules. And, well, as you can see here, we have a special kind of chain rule in this example. Because, a chain rule is a rule where you have one non-terminal on the left-hand side and one non-terminal on the right-hand side, and that's what we call a chain rule. And basically everything that the second one can become, the first one can become two, because it's like It's like you would exchange the first one by the second one. So in this case, we have a very special chain rule, because the A can derive to a C, and the C can derive back to an A, and that's what we call a circle, where we have another circle with A and B. You could take care of this as well, but it doesn't really matter how you do the steps, so I choose to do it with A and C. And I can remove the circle with A and C by replacing A and C by new non-terminals. So I could call it, for example, well, I could just call it X. And, well, let me just replace it. Well, I replace this line by a new rule where I have replaced A by an X. So I have a new rule, X goes to B, and, well, I would replace the C by an X. So now I can take out this rule, and now I want to exchange this line where C would be a new X for me as well, because as I said, I replace the circle by replacing A and C by an X. So, and this X becomes a B, or, well, I said this A would be an X as well. And as you can see, now those two lines are, let me take this out first. As you can see, these two lines are the same, so I don't need the second one anymore. And of course, X goes to X, that is useless, so I can take this out as well. And now I have to replace some more A's, so here's an A left. I take it out and replace it by my new non-terminal X. And here I have an A as well, so I take it out and replace it by a new X. And now I don't have any A's or C's anymore, so I take them out of the set of non-terminals. So, and, well, we have another chain rule left. Yeah, and we have to take care about it. We have one B becomes an X. Well, and we have X becomes B, so I can do the same again and replace them by a new non-terminal. I could call it X2 or something. So let me take this first. So I would have X2 goes to X2. I will take it out later because it's trivial. So then I would like to replace this line where X2 becomes becomes BX2 or becomes A or becomes my another X2. I will take it out later. So I can remove this line. And now I have here a B left. So I will replace this rule by even another rule. AAX2. And of course I replaced this X by X2 as well. So now I have to take out this one and this one because I don't really need them. And now we don't have any chain rules anymore, but, well, I would like to copy the left S part to here below so we can better see it. So we have left S becomes or derives to BX2 or to AAX2. So I take this away. And now we have one step left. and that would be binarizing. Binarize. And that's the last step to bring all left rules into this form. Oh, I forgot to take out the B, and of course I have to add my new non-terminal X2 to the set. So now we want to binarize. First, when we have mixed rules like this, where we have a non-terminal and a terminal on the right-hand side, we now have to replace the terminal by a new non-terminal. And well, let me call it, for example, F that goes to B. Well, I need one new rule for each non-terminal, so I take F goes to B and G goes to A, and now I can use these rules to replace A and B wherever I need it. For example, here, where we have those mixed rules. So I take it away and add another one where I replace those B by an ZF. So, and I take this away. And here's the same. I have to replace the B. And here we have even the same, but I have to replace A by G. So I add 2G and those X2, and I take this out again. And we have here a right-hand side where we have a single terminal, and that matches this rule pattern. So this single rule here is completely fine, and I don't touch it anymore. And now we have here a single rule left, right-hand side, where we have three non-terminals, but only two are allowed. And what I do is I add even another non-terminal. Well, you will see every time you create a Chomsky normal form, you will add a lot of new non-terminals. But I have to add another new non-terminal that I call H, or... well, you could name every one of it X and give it numbers, so X1, X2, X3, or you can use the alphabet, it doesn't really matter. I take H in this case, and now I can decide if I want to join the both G into one rule, or if I want to join G with X2 in a new rule. In this case, I choose the two G's. And now I replace in this rule the two G's by my new H and get something like this. And now, as you can see, we have this set of rules left. Here, those rules are left, which I did not cross out. And now we have a grammar in Chomsky normal form. And as you can see, every rule that is left matches one of the two patterns.